was looking at some camper ideas for the gaming PC setup that I have planned in my head. I think I've got some really good ideas for it too, so I'm kind of excited when eventually I can get it down here. It's pretty exciting. I'm thinking about getting some solar panels for it too. And I've got like a whole setup in my head of how I can get all that to be tucked away nice and safe, but still very, very efficient. So, but also so I can be like as OTG as possible, which is nice. Off the grid, baby. Non-existent. Steamworks Overdrive button. I have. Yeah, apparently that's a thing. So what's your opinion on the guiding lens?
Yeah. Is that where you're at now?
I really like it a lot, personally. Yeah, for sure. Hey, so if I were to upgrade my PC, what would be the first thing you think I should upgrade? Should it be the graphics card? Yeah. Cause I was thinking I should upgrade the processor to get more cores so I can stream a little bit more effectively. Cause I don't really think the GPU,
the GPU is definitely a throttle.
It's definitely a throttle, you said? Oh.
It's always the bottleneck.
Oh, okay. So if I get a better GPU, I shouldn't have any problems with the stream and Monster Hunter running?
Monster Hunter specifically, you might have a few. But it'll still be, if you use hardware current for your stream, it won't be an issue.
Gotcha. If I run my stream off the GPU, is that what you mean?
Reduces the amount of CPU needed to encode the stream.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah.
That's how I was doing it.
Oh, gotcha.
So, even if you don't have the best CPU, you can offload a lot of the work to the GPU and then it ends up being, perfectly fine.
Gotcha. Are you online?
Yeah, I'm already in
I don't see you. I don't see you on. solar panels, nice gaming setup, and I think I'm gonna paint the inside too. I don't know, I've been thinking about it a lot. Just now, kind of thinking out loud about it, but yeah. I'm just so excited. It's gonna be cool. It's gonna be dope.
Yeah. As long as it's something you made and you like, then it's cool. That's how these things work. Oh, he's here. It's a bit smaller than I expected it to be.
The area, really?
Yeah. Considering all the different biomes, I'm just like expecting one or two more areas at least to find, but I'm not finding them. And I feel like they should be there. So the top area feels very empty.
Is there a bottom area?
Oh, is there a rotten area? Mm. It's kind of insane. They're literally just like swarming around me and just snapping me over and over and paralyzing me. Assholes. I don't know why they kept them in the game, dude. They're just annoying.
They are, really. But, I mean, you know, what's a good... It's not a monster in a game, unless if you get paralyzed by Vespoids or Benabras.
Don't remind me of Benabras. Banana Habra.
The Banana Habra. Well, I mean, at least they didn't bring Vespoid Queen back, so that's pretty good.
Well, thank God.
I remember having to do that fight, and you told me about how bad it was, and I was like, nah, it can't be that bad.
It's pretty bad.
It's pretty terrible.
It's just not enjoyable.
Underwhelming for you?
It feels a little empty at the moment. But I mean, I know that's not like... That's probably not the case, knowing Monster Hunter. I just can't figure out what I'm missing and how to find it.
I think I've found like a whole new... thing up here. I wonder if that's a spot, actually. Oh, it's like a good camping spot. Right behind me, straight ahead.
No, no, that's a nest area.
Yeah. I'm gonna go look at it. Jagras is going there, too. Weird.
What is?
That whole area I just was in, the nest you were talking about?
Yeah. The place is kind of cool. It's like super lush.
Yeah. Yeah, I do like this area a lot. I don't know, man. I guess I'm the exact opposite about kind of how I feel about it. I think it's pretty vast in terms of like,
well, I mean,
areas
like
at least.
Space.
Yeah.
But maybe I need to fight in it, like, on the rig. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Areas seem to feel a bit more alive in those situations.
I mean, you do have a gun.
Yeah, I just shot them onto that.
cleanse the world of their
pestilence.
Oh, damn, you're high. Jesus. Yeah, I'm down.
Where's it going? I can't, like, claw onto him. Oh, he just went into a fucking... Okay. Did he just leave? Where did he... He left the area. That fucker.
Nice. I think Ben Barrow is about to leave, too. I guess that's it for the preparation around here.
Yeah, I've gone over it a bunch. I need to level up the area. That's what it is.
I think leveling up the areas only changes the monsters. I don't know if it changes the appearance. Does it? Yeah. How did you start it?
You could do it from the handler.
Oh. Okay, well, I'll come back. I do want to change weapons, though. Trying to see if I can make switch hats, potentially. Oh, have you seen the new armors for these monsters?
Some, yeah.
I think I like a lot of them. Teostra's pretty dope, too. I think Kushala's always been weird for me, though. It's a little bit too... I don't know. Interesting. Definitely not Kieran. But Namiel is pretty awesome.
Yeah, he's definitely got a really cool vibe.
Yeah. Like, look at his armor for my character. Let me change the colors real quick.
Well, he looks like the Inkling from, Splatoon?
Yeah. But it's cool because, like, the helmet. It gives off like a one eye, like burning effect, which I think is pretty nice. And it glows like he does, so. Kind of into it.
Yeah,
And I can change the color to whatever I want. Might have to. Might have to grind that armor.
Grind it, grind it. Well,
oh, yeah. What's he do?
You're going to have
to see for yourself. Little. How am I going to describe it? Nuts. He's definitely visually terrifying. Ouch. Oh, fuck. He does it twice. Do it.
A really nice Velcana switch adds, so I'm gonna come in now. You're not open.
Somebody might have taken the last slot. Yeah, somebody took the last slot.
Nice.
What'd you get for taking your time, dude?
What? I was making a new weapon.
Wait.
Probably just digging around. I tell you. Dude, I got so triggered on stream earlier today because I had like 3 squad members and all of them just stood there and watched me die. Not a single one of them used life powders like I'd been using the entire quest, keeping the rest of the team alive. I was so mad. I caught all of it on stream. That was great. But anyway, yeah. He hit pretty hard.
He hits pretty hard.
Oh, poop. Alright. Where are you boys at? Oh, there he is. Oh, shit. Hi. Ooh. That's new. Die as many times as we want, right? Shiny over here. cap him. Dude, I can't place the trap over there. I had to place it over here. Jesus. Nice. Nice. Sweet. Well, now what?
Now what?
Mm-hmm.
Now we can return to my expedition if you want.
This is cool. I kind of like this. It's like a free range, basically.
Yeah, you can just do whatever you want.
Yeah, it's perfect. I don't have any objectives. Do you?
Any what?
Like any main story objectives on the side?
No.
Are we like done with, I guess, with the...
With the main story, yeah. Now it's just grind till we get,
Yeah.
Till we get... What's it called?
Everything?
Sapijila.
Oh. What's that?
I really want to see when Rajan is supposed to show up. Because I want to fight that fucking thing really bad.
Ooh. We need to level everything up to 6.
To do what?
To unlock the good shit. You want me to tell you? Or who? Or, I guess?
Sure.
So, Yandruga, level 3 in the Ancient Forest. Gold, silver, and brute tigrets appear at level 6 with a wild spire, coral, and rotten veil. I don't know, some Yandruga sounds pretty nostalgic right about now.
Dude, that fucker.
There's even a new version of him in this game. Yeah, apparently if you get regular Yandruga, there is a... an assigned quest will appear for him, Yandruga, when reaching level 3 in the Ancient Forest area. Starred Yandruga will first appear in Ancient Forest region at level 6, only has a tempered form.
What the fuck?
Yo, Black Veil Balazsakar actually has a really damn good skill.
Yeah, I saw it. I kind of want to grind it. That and Namiel.
And which one?
Namiel.
Oh, Namiel?
Yeah.
Namiel's actually not bad for me because of the true element acceleration.
Mm-hmm.
But it's better for melee weapons than it is for bow gun.
Mm.
What mantles do I need for that armor? Yeah, it's like Rathian and Ergon Pallium, I think.
I'm not sure. The Ergon, Large Elder Dragon Gem, Rathian Mantle, and the Fae Gem.
Perfect gun.
Well, for a spread build.
No.
It's the Snow Gray heavy bow gun.
Oh yeah.
Spread 1, 2, and 3 holds 12, 8, and 6 in that order. Recoil low, average in that order. Mm. Reload speed all normal without mods.
It's pretty good. Yes.
It's Wyvern Heart. It's got a 2-level slot and low deviation with 0% affinity. 375 raw, and that's not even the highest version of it.
Jeez.
The highest version of it is... I can't even see the highest version of it yet. I don't have it unlocked. But Lightning Plus is 405 attack with the same. It has all 5 mod slots. And then, of course, the top version probably just has more damage. And has augmentation slots. Ooh, the light bulbs on Rapid Fire's thunder. But it's really not that great. You want to fight Velcana?
Sure.
I can almost get the dual swords. But, I also want to look at the lance. it's crazy to me that this late in the game, is there are still items I
don't have
run into yet. Like, what the fuck? There's a whole set of items. I bet you that's Jan Garuga.
Probably. I mean, there's a few that we haven't fought yet, honestly. Like the, you know, Safi, Yon, Tigritz, the Rathalos and Rathian combo. I feel like there's one more, too. I can't remember the name of it, though.
Actually, I could grind out for the final heavy bowgun in the Narukuga line. Because all I need is a mantle and 3 Fulgur engine.
I need a Fey Wyvern Gem for my final piece of armor for the Namiel set.
You can craft anything. Yeah, you can.
I can't.
You need a Celestial.
Oh, well, I just... Yeah, I used both mine. Yeah, I don't have any more.
Well, what do you want to do?
I mean, I'm good right now. I can just go with you. Whatever you want. Maisie.
Let's go hunt some Fulgur engine.
Okay. Seaweed to ice? I hope so.
Check your hunter's notes.
Oh, yeah.
Doesn't really matter to me because I use non-elemental damage.
Actually, I don't know. It doesn't say for me because I haven't fought him enough, I guess. I'll be fine. Ish.
Are you in my session?
I don't think so.
You want to just shoot up the SOS flare instead?
Here, I'll join you. Did you already leave for the quest?
No, still there.
Can't find it. You have it up, right?
Yeah, it's up. It's an optional.
Oh,
quest.
You have it. Okay, all right. I was looking in the guiding lands.
Oops. Not guiding lands, no. It's just an actual quest. Because I don't think Fulgur Engineff is unlocked in the guiding lands yet.
Alright, I'm gonna go to the right. You wanna take the left? Ready? To sleep in. Whoops. Okay. Napper time. You didn't? You want me to give you mine?
You got it, just put it down.
Okay. Alright.
Ready?
Start? Yep. Oh, David, you missed. Thank you. Well, that was kind of easy, actually.
Well, he's very easy to kill with Logan.
Oh, really?
There's a lot of like, weak spots on him. They're critically weak to Logan. And he's easy to line up, tail the head.
Yeah.
So I'm doing like, feels like at least 100 damage per shot. Bigger monsters are easier to pierce.
I should get one of these for my desk, IRL. I missed my time's up. I can't get to that jester fast enough. Damn. I had to go in and redo my radial settings. Now that I've got it to where I can pull things out of my loadouts, my set loadouts, and then not have to worry about them, so I can get used to that system. So I feel like that would help me out a lot with a lot of the problems that I've been having, at least. Or not really problems, it's just speeding things up, I guess.
Beating things up.
Beating the shit out of things faster. And then kabuki dance on the corpse. Blah, blah.
Be like that one sumo wrestling anime or whatever.
I know what you're talking about. I don't remember what it's called.
I watched it. I just know it was a thing.
He has a special sumo wrestling technique, I'm sure. That nobody else can master. Yeah.
And he's like really stupidly strong. he's just awesome.
Are there, like, rare items that you find in mining crops like we used to in the older games, or no?
You can in, the Guiding Lands. But I think they're still ore-specific, like, items.
Yeah.
No! What?
Nice.
I collected some. I know I did. I carved one off of them.
Oh, they're not in your box. Go put them in your box, bro.
How are they out of my box?
If you carved them off, right?
No, they go to your fucking materials pouch, and when you come back from the questing, you immediately go to your...
In your box. What do you got in mind? You want to go back to the Guiding Lands and level that up for Count Garuda?
Yes. How about you do your Guiding Lands and I'll join you?
Okay. I think mine level up the same as yours.
It should level up from the same activities.
Yeah. How do you ready up for a quest? You just hit depart and then it sets it up? Or does it automatically?
Once you get out there, you need to set up for there.
Gotcha.
no, apparently I can literally just join you.
Oh, cool. So what do we need to do, I guess?
You need to...
To level up the...
Find tracks.
Forest.
Okay, there are a couple ways you can level up the forest. In the top right, you see that analysis progress?
Yeah.
You can collect tracks.
Mm-hmm.
Or hunt monsters of those types. And eventually you will unlock the little footprint, which is a special track. And the special track can be used to basically summon a version of that monster to an area of the guiding lens that you can fight.
Interesting.
So, like, rare monsters that you wouldn't normally find out here, like Zenogre, you can do that.
Hmm.
And I think that's the mechanic for unlocking new monsters, is you have to do that.
Oh, it's, I don't know. So I guess Coral Pookie Pookie would be the one then.
Yeah, that would be a flying bird.
kit?
It was over here?
Yeah, it's like this stuff over here. He like broke off a bunch of rocks on the wall. But I don't know what it revealed. It's just like this rock stuff.
Hmm.
It for me.
Oh.
Bunvaro's back.
Thank you.
Oh, crap. Set off that turd. Like 100 damage with this.
Yay.
Nice. Holy shit. That was nuts. I do, I don't know, man. Switch hats is definitely not for me either. I think I like Hunting Horn a little bit more. I need to switch back to it and get that sleeping one I was telling you about.
Sleeping Hunting Horn.
Oh yeah, especially with all those buffs that it had, man. They sleep in and stuff. God dang it. Do we want to fight something else in the area or no?
We can't. It's up to you.
I want to go back and check on that Hunting Horn. Holy fuck, did you just jump from the sky?
Yeah.
Holy yeah. Oh god. Oh, no. Oh, God. He's come back. Wait. Okay. Good. Ow. That's such a reach, dude. Yeah, what the fuck? Alright. Does it only affect my hunting rewards when I die?
No, I think it affects everyone's. Really? Typical monster hunter fare, you know.
Oh. Well, in that case, time for me to turn it in. After analyzing special type, then talk to the handler and one of the guys and select lure out monster to decide where you want to appear. It may take some time, but this is an efficient way to get the materials ready. Interesting. Oh, but if you turn in your investigation, I guess before you die or like when you're done with the monster, it doesn't affect those rewards. I still have quite a few. Even after 2 deaths.
Yeah. It's a great way to grind materials.
Oh, dude, nut.
Although, I'll be honest, I kind of want to fight Shara Ishvalda again.
Okay.
Because he was fun.
Okay. I'm down. I don't know if I have the quest or not, though. I think it's like the same as Zora and Zeno.
We can check.
I'm already master rank 75. I think getting to 100 would be fairly easy. Do you know if... Oh no, stretch head. I'm HR 75. I'm Master Rank 41. You're actually, I think you're higher than me.
Makes sense. I tease. I wonder if you can just, like, go to that area on the map? Nope. Well, we can always just join SOS.
Yeah. If you find a fairly empty one, I'll be done.
found two of them. I'm gonna go use the bathroom. You can choose either one. Or, Okay, I'm gonna see what I can do with this sleep hammer. Pookie Pookie Quill. I need quite a few of them, actually, to get this. Actually, no. I just need Pookie Pookie, Shamos, Palumu, and then I should be good.
There's only one spot left.
Okay, come in.
I think you missed it.
Fuck. Yeah, I don't see it. That's alright. I'm gonna go hunt that Pookie Pookie then. Whoa, I didn't know about that.
これから しがみつく攻撃法を教えよう。この攻撃は装備する武器により性質が異なる。そうだな。今装備している武器ならモンスターの肉質を下げる効果があるな。次に進む前にしがみつくタイミングについて教えよう。これは重要だぞ。モンスター モンスター相手に試してみよう。モンスターの攻撃に注意しながら攻撃を当てろ。焦るな。攻撃してモンスターのひるみを狙え。
次に教える。しがみつき中の攻撃はモンスターの頭部を狙ったものだ。モンスターにもよるが、しがみつける部位はいくつかある。しがみついてからも他の部位へ飛び移ることはできるが、スタミナを消費する。狙った場所にしがみつけるよう、しっかりねらえよ。これを行うにはスリンガーの弾が必要だ。弾を探して装填してくれ。まずはモンスターを攻撃し、ひるんで動きが止まったところを狙うんだ。
スリンガーを使え。よし、いいぞ。この攻撃はスリンガー弾を全弾消費するな。モンスターを大きく吹っ飛ばすことができる。それでは次に進もう。次に教えるのはクロウを使った攻撃方法だ。この攻撃はモンスターの頭部にしがみついて行う。まずはモンスターを攻撃し、 ひるんで動きが止まったところを狙うんだ。止まった。しがみつけ。クロウ攻撃。モンスターの向きを変えるんだ。よし、いいぞ。もう一度やってみよう。スタミナの攻撃が激しいが、連続で向き返えすることも可能だ。
教えるのは、これまでの教えを応用した攻撃方法だ。この攻撃は周囲の環境を利用する。しがみつき中に行ったぶっ飛ばし攻撃でモンスターを壁に激突させるんだ。成功したら大きなチャンスが生まれる。自分の力で成功させてくれ。モンスターの状況を観察するんだ。怒り中はぶっ飛びも、吹き替えも効かない。
hit, you die?
It's so much harder.
Really?
Yes.
Harder, like, what do you mean? So that was just the, that was like the basic quest, right?
No. This is the 6-star master.
Oh, that's
This is the actual quest. And it's just like, alright. Keep doing your thing. I need to put down for at least a little bit here. I'm good to snap. Keep doing your thing though. You're good to keep going.
A nappy?
Yeah. I'm gonna leave the light on and turn off this real quick.
Okay.
ご機嫌よう。 ごきげんよう。 はいかがですか?